Hi, this is Amish Agarwal. I'm an advocate. I practice law in Delhi. I'm today outside Noida District Courts where I had a couple of matters, and I wanted to talk about why this particular advocate hates court vacations. You see, advocacy is the art of going to court, screaming at the top of your lungs like I am right now, and trying to convince the judge that you have a stronger case than your opponents. And it's famous, like India's court systems are famous for having almost a month or a 1.5 month long vacations in the high courts and the Supreme Court, and even a minimum of a 2 or 3 week summer vacation during the summers, and even perhaps a 1 week to a 1 month vacation during the winter time. And every single time I've been through several cycles of those summer vacations, winter vacations, and every single time I come out July or be it January, it's always a nightmare for me, because I realize that, you know, this thing of advocacy, a lot of people say, how do you kind of get better at it? Like any other skill, it's just about practice and consistent effort. And whenever I have that one break of a month or a week or 2 weeks or 3 weeks in not going, and I don't go to court in that time, and I'm not standing there, and I'm not going through that grind, I'm not going through the stress, the fluency in my oral arguments, I always find myself at a huge loss. You see, what happens is that when I go to court and I'm arguing after maybe a gap of 10 days or 15 days or 20 days, I start feeling very, very jittery. I start stuttering with my words. I am slow. I am not so quick on my feet. I don't know how much other lawyers feel like this, but I do. And apart from that, another thing, you know, I'm a fat guy. And I mean, you know, even irrespective of weight, I've seen a lot of times when you go to court, you have to stand there for hours and hours at a single go, because you want to be sure that, you know, like the matter, the thing that's going on, sometimes you don't even have a space to sit. So in all of these situations, you need to have the capability, the stamina to stand for several hours. And even when you're doing cross examinations, when you're addressing arguments which are going on for several hours, these are all situations in which you will face a little bit of, you know, this kind of an issue. And so, you know, like when I go to court and I'm standing here after maybe like a month or 2 months, I have become so used to that cocoon of comfort in my own house and in my own office of sitting the entire time, that I feel pain in my legs for the first 2 or 3 or 4 days when I go to court. And of course, right now, August of 2020, and now September of 2020 is the corona time, in which several lawyers may or may not feel what I have felt, but this break, that this summer vacation stretched out for not maybe 1 week or 1 month, but almost 5 or 6 months. And of course, I've been doing a lot of arguments, I've been doing a lot of online hearings in Delhi, I've been coming to Noida court regularly, I've been coming to Gurgaon court, I even went to Ghaziabad for one case. And you know, the flow is there, but I still don't feel that kind of intensity that I used to back in the day, when we would have matters every single day before a court, and sometimes multiple matters, and we are running from court to court, and we've got savage opposing lawyers, you've got savage clients, you've got savage opposing the clients, which are the savage opposite side, right? The litigants. You've got all of these people to deal with. Your verbal fluency, your mental, you know, sharpness, all of that gets compromised to a huge level whenever you are not in that flow. And that is the reason why, ladies and gentlemen, this particular advocate hates court vacations. That's it.